our colleagues. Once again, we are very much thankful to you, sir. We are also thankful to Mrs. Borde for having accepted our invitation and come over here along with Justice Borde, sir. We are thankful to our secretary, Sri Gandhi sir, for having accepted our invitation to preside over this graduation ceremony. We are also thankful to Sri Ramchandra Dere sir, president of our Ahmednagar Jilla Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samaj, having accepted our invitation to be here with us. We are also thankful to our senior trustee, Sri Graduate Ramnath Deva, having accepted our invitation and to be with us on this day. We are also thankful to Sri G.K. Patil sir, General Council member of our samstha. We are also thankful to Graduate Mone sir, LMC member of our law college, Vice Principal Bombay sir, and graduation ceremony secretary Moite sir, and other invitees, members of the press. And we are also thankful to Sri Advocate Atre Patil, trustee of our Ahmednagar Jilla Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samaj, to be here on this graduation ceremony. And I consider it as a great privilege to be with this the chief guest and management of our samstha, the members of our faculty and passing out students on the occasion of our first graduation ceremony of this college. Graduation ceremony is the most important and memorable day in academic life of a student, but also a joyous occasion for the college. As a whole, on this occasion, I wish to offer my hearty congratulations to all those students who are taking LLM and LLB and BSL LLB degrees and BSL degrees on this occasion. This is an unforgettable day in the life, in their life, and they will cherish every moment of this day in their life. On the event of this graduation ceremony, I share the joy of my students who are graduating from this prestigious new law college, Ahmednagar. This is therefore an occasion for us, for the teachers and parents, to wish passing out students all success and happiness in their future. In their future pursuits. My dear students, those who are graduating as law graduates, so now we are lucky this profession offers n number of opportunities. Besides litigation advocate, much of the practice is thrown available by virtue of globalization and liberalization policies. Now, in corporate companies, every company, they are appointing in-house lawyers, there are transaction lawyers, and so many law firms have come up which do transactional business, including the business relating to international trade. According to knowledgeable circles, by the end of this century, 50% of the global trade will be around services only. And another advantage, very often being the, my dear students, very often being the right place at the right time helps and makes all the difference between modest and outstanding success. The richest software billionaires, Bill Gates and Steve Jobs, were all born in this mid-70s and joined the college at the starting point of computer revolution. So you are joining the profession at the moment where law offers many opportunities. Therefore, there is an added advantage for you. And there is no substitute of hard work. As you, even persons like Mani Palki Baba, initially want to become a lecturer, but by God's grace, he became advocate. Now even still stands no parallel for him. Dr. Meenan, in an article, Provisions for the People, this legal provision is one of the noblest provision, and by taking into ethical and constitutional mandates of the Constitution, he says one can attribute the role and responsibility of the provision, namely, one, provisions have important role in directing and moderating social change, and it and in this regard have to operate as the conscience keepers of the society. Therefore, there are these provision bodies, they are given autonomy in organizing and administering provisional services like Bar Council of India. Next, provisions particularly of law and medicine and teaching will manifest higher moral values, maintain high degree of competence and discipline, and to ensure that no section of the society is denied of access to its services because of poverty or social status. Third, provisions are supposed to influence the governmental policies on social justice issues. Provisions are to correct governmental wrongs, increase efficiency of public institutions, and strive for higher standards of excellence and achievement in all spheres of activities. I am happy on this occasion my students are joining in this greatest noble profession. So India has a very long professional people, and it is in the world, it is next to the US. Justice Krishna here says that a study of law becomes an imperative if societies with members of high and low are to be civilized, stable and humanist. Now, lawyer's job is made easy and difficult also as a result of the information explosion and communication revolution modern technology has produced. And now I will impress upon our young graduates entering the profession, use technology, open e-offices so that you can compete with your contemporaries, because your contemporaries are getting more information unlike the traditional lawyers who are practicing at that time. Only the books are the source. Now you are having lot of sources. If your contemporary take advantage of the technology, if you are not taking, there will not be any level playing field. Therefore, I will advise my graduate students now passing out to use technology in our profession. With this view, Dhanyavaad.